Hi, welcome to this video lecture. Myself V. Jeevanandam, working as assistant professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, SSM Institute of Engineering and Technology, Dindigul. In this video lecture, we will discuss few things about biotelemetry system, which is recent advancement in medical electronics field. Let me share the PPT of this session. So first of all, what is biotelemetry? Telemetry is a technology that allows a remote measurement and reporting of information. The word tele is derived from Greek, which is remote, and metron is measure, which is collectively called as telemetry. The term commonly refers to wireless data transfer mechanisms. It also encompasses data transfer over the media such as telephone or computer network, optical link, and other wired communication system. Many modern telemetry systems take advantage of the low cost and ubiquity of GSM networks by using SMS to receive and transmit telemetry data. Biotelemetry is the measurement of biological parameters over long distance for conveying biological related information from a living organism and its environment to a different location where this can be recorded. This involves radio frequency signal as a carrier for modulation, referred to as radio telemetry. This is presently used in various remote areas like tribal area to give treatment for the tribal peoples from the doctors in the urban areas. So this is the basic block diagram of biotelemetry system. The basic elements are biological signals which are derived from the living organisms, then that is converted to electrical signals using any type of transducers based on the application. Then for the communication purpose, the signal level is very low, so we have to strengthen the signal for long distance communication. For that we go for amplification. Then after amplification, filtering is done by conditioning circuits, that is filter circuits. Then we based on the requirement, we use different types of channels to communicate with the doctors in the urban areas. The output is based on the different types of medical modalities like MRIs, ECG, X-ray, based on the type of modalities the doctors used in the rural end or transmission end. The doctors or radiologists come to an observation based on the images. So in this, to measure ECG, EEG, EMG signals, electrodes act as transducers. For measuring temperatures, thermistor is used as transducers. For measuring blood pressure, strain gauge is used as transducer. Like that, for measuring stomach pH value, glass electrode is used as electrodes. Then, while designing the biotelemetry system, some of the care should be taken like this. The first one is the telemetry system should be selected to transmit the bioelectric signal with maximum fidelity and simplicity. The system should not affect living system by any type of interferences. It should have more stability and reliability. The power consumption at the transmitter and at the receiver should be small to extend the source lifetime in the case of implanted units. The size and weight of the telemetry system should be very compact. For wire transmission, the shielding of cable must reduce noise levels at the transmitter side. The amplifiers should be differential amplifiers to reject common mode interference. Miniaturization of the radio telemetry system help to reduce noise. Then, based on the types of, based on the number of channels, the radio telemetry system further classified into two types. First one is single channel telemetry system, and the next one is multi-channel telemetry system. First, we will discuss single channel telemetry system. As the name impels, the channel consists only one, sorry, the system consists only one channel. A single channel telemetry system consists of the stages of typical biotelemetry system broken down into functional blocks shown in figure, like transmitter and receiver. For a single channel system, a miniature battery operated radio transmitter is connected to the electrodes of the patient. This transmitter broadcasts the biopotential to a remotely located receiver. The receiver detects the radio signals and recovers the signal for further processing. Physiological signals are obtained from the subject by means of appropriate transducers. The signal is then passed through a stage of conditioning circuit where amplification and processing is done. Later, the processed signal is transmitted using radio transmitter. The radio frequency used in this system varies from few hundred kilohertz to 300 megahertz. Either amplitude modulation, that is AM, or frequency modulation, FM, can be used. But due to reduced interference, FM transmission is mostly used for telemetry. Next, subcarrier system. So because of using single carrier, the loading effect will affect the transmission in the telemetry system. So for that, we go for additional carrier, that is called subcarrier. In transmitter side, when the position of the transmitter to the body or other conduction object change, the carrier frequency and amplitude will change due to the loading change of the carrier frequency resonant circuit. If the signal has a frequency different from the loading effect, they can be separated by filters. Otherwise, the real signal will be destroyed by loading effect. So to avoid this loading effect, the subcarrier system is needed. The signal is modulated on a subcarrier to convert the signal frequency to the neighborhood of the subcarrier frequency. Then RF carrier is modulated by this subcarrying signal. The 20 kilohertz subcarrier signal is usually given to the amplitude modulator. The signals are amplified and forward to the transmitter. In the receiver side, the receiver detects the RF and recovers the subcarrying signal. At the receiver side, the signals are passed to demodulated. Demodulated signal is filtered, amplified, and by amplifier, and then they are given to additional demodulator because we are using one more carrier system, that is subcarrier system. Finally, the signal is retrieved. Next one, multi-channel telemetry system. So in some type of biomedical application, simultaneously we have to record more number of bio signals. So in those conditions, we are using more than one channel. So by using a single channel, we are not able to transmit more type of bio signals. For that, we go for multi-channel telemetry system. In biotelemetry system, we are presently using two types of multiplexing techniques for multi-channel operation. First one is FDM, that is frequency division multiplexing. The next one is time division multiplexing. So this is the block diagram of frequency division multiplexing. So in frequency division multiplexing system, each bio signal is frequency modulated on a subcarrier frequency. Then this modulated subcarrier frequency are combined to modulate the main RF carrier, that is radio frequency carrier. At the receiver side in frequency division multiplexing system, modulated subcarriers will be separated by the proper bandpass filters after the discrimination. Various types of discrimination available in communication systems. Later, the individual signals are recovered from those modulated subcarriers by the second set of discriminators, that is additional discriminator, that which is used for demodulators, which is called as demodulators. The frequency of the subcarriers has to be carefully selected to avoid interference. The low pass filters used to extract the signals without any noise. Next type of multiplexing is time division multiplex telemetry system. This is the block diagram of time division multiplex telemetry system. Most of the biomedical signals have low frequency bandwidth requirements, so time division multiplex system can be used by time sharing basis. So the transmission channel is connected to each signal channel input for a short time to sample and transmit the signal. Then the transmitter is switched to the next signal channel in a definite sequence. When all the channels have been scanned, the operation is repeated from the first channel. At the receiver end, the process is reversed. The sequentially arranged signal pulses are distributed to the individual channels by a synchronized switching circuit. Next, advantages of biotelemetry systems. So the it is used to record various biosignals over long periods. So patients is not disturbed using recording time. For future reference or study purposes, the recorded data will be very useful. Then it is used for monitoring the athletes running races or any type of sports activities, for monitoring the persons who are in action or movement. The biotelemetry is an ideal one. For recording on animals, particularly for research, the biotelemetry is greatly used. Next, applications of biotelemetry. In many situations, it becomes necessary to monitor physiological events from a distance, that is from a remote area. So these are the some of the applications area of biotelemetry system. First one is radio frequency transmission for monitoring the health of astronauts in space. Then patient monitoring in an ambulance and in other locations away from the hospital. Collection of medical data from home or office. Patient monitoring where freedom of movement is desired, such as in obtaining an exercise ECG. In this instance, the requirement of trailing wires is very dangerous. So biotelemetry system is applied in this area. Then research on unrestrained and unanesthetized animals in their natural habitat. So to study about the behavior of animals in forest area without disturbing their regular activities, by using biotelemetry we can achieve. Then special internal techniques such as measuring pH or pressure in the gastrointestinal tract. Then isolation of electrically susceptible patient from power line operated ECG equipments to protect him from accidental shock. So in these are the applications of biotelemetry. These are only the few applications. Other than this, many more applications are there. Thank you.